All right, so we got something. It should be working now. All right, so now that we got those technical difficulties out of the way, Happy New Year, everybody. Hoping everybody's having a great, fresh day of 2020. Obviously, I wasn't because we were having problems with the stream. So, yeah, there's always that. But we got coffee, so. At any rate, let's get down to it and do some work. Do some serious work. Excuse me. On the map today. I'm trying to get my Facebook to reload here. Okay. So, let's figure this out here. All right. Oh, do, no. All right, so here, let me. Okay, we got at least one person on. So welcome, thank you. So all right, let's get some work done here. I bought field 78, which still needs to get planted. I'm gonna go down here to field 2 and finish plowing here and get this done because it needs to be done. Let's try to get the. Okay, so anyway. Plows in the ground, right? Yep. Lock the GPS line on. Anyway, so again. Happy New Year. Enjoying this free sabbatical day at home. Gonna try to do a couple live streams today. Now that everything's playing nice with each other. So, alright, so still got a bit more work to do here in field 2. Get this plowed up, needs to be done. And then I'll probably get a course plate worker going on another field I have, the one that I just bought. So, this up and turn around. Yeah, I got no idea why it wasn't allowing me to go live. I've done it before, no matter. Got it going now. And that's all that matters. Got it fixed. Just work through the problems. So, let me see. Pop the cruise on. Go. Where's my comments? I want to see them. For whatever reason, I might have to bring it up. I might have to bring it up on my screen here. Okay, let's do 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 do. Okay. Let me move this around. Let me move this over here so I can see what's going on. Nope. Minimize. Bring this over top. Seeing as so I can see. Nope. The comments. So, alright, let's get back to it. And for whatever reason, I decided to jump out of that tractor. Alright. Thanks for the shares, everybody. Appreciate that. Trying to get a few watches and views and things like that. Keep people coming to the Facebook page. So awesome. Fire this thing back up. Oh, there we go. So. Alright. Again, thank you everybody. Everybody, appreciate it. So, I still gotta do headlands on this end of the field because all the trees that are there. I'll do that last. Just get the rest of this going and get it basically done. I'd like to plant this field in, oh man, corn maybe, just to chop into silage, because it's not super big, so it'll create a metric ton of silage, because at some point I need to get a dairy farm set up and get that going. So. This is just pre-planning. See, and now it's lagging like a son of a gun. I don't understand why it's lagging so bad. It's probably because I'm trying to do too many things at the same time. So, let's try to fix this up. So... close that. Move this over here a little bit. So, we should be doing okay now. We should be alright again. So, let's try that again. I think I just had too much stuff running in the background. Because when I get encoder errors, it gets really laggy and freezes and looks like crap. So, try this some more. Get the bugs worked out of it. You know, we're not perfect. It's still pretty new. Still pretty new to this. So, trying my best. Fumbling through. All right, get turned around. I know most of you are probably off today, but I know there's a few of them friends of mine who are out towing, trying to make a living, so. All of those of you whom are in the towing and recovery industry, if you're out working a day, by all means, stay safe. I know how hazardous it can be. The unsung heroes But so far, so far this turbo chisel is working out pretty darn good. It's still a little small, but it's a lot bigger than the other Great Plains turbo chisel. I'm hoping to try it out with coarse play to see how well it plays with that. Otherwise, I have another disc that works as a plow that I can use. I don't think any other of my fields need to be plowed at the moment, other than this one. If I have to fast forward time another day or so, I might even just try to get corn and soybeans planted just a little early, in hopes that we won't have any issues with any germination problems, because the ground temp still isn't quite warm enough to do so. But as soon as this field's done, jump into that, check that out. I got equipment over here that needs to get moved back. I probably need to plow up that field as well. But it does currently have grass on it, which I've already harvested once this spring. Man, you just can't beat the GPS mod. You really just can't. Allows you to do a few other things while you're, trying to get some work done. Turned around. And the reaction time of this turbo chisel is pretty fast, so I can't really complain too much. Super, super happy thus far. As you can see, I'm running floats on the old John Deere. This is the updated 8R from Custom. So they put a lot of time and effort into it, into all of their mods, for that matter. A lot of time and effort. So I definitely appreciate all of their hard work. Oh, we got at least three people watching. Hey, welcome, welcome. If you haven't shared, please share. Appreciate it. This field's so short, it seems like you're doing more turning around than anything else. Takes a couple minutes. I mean, there's probably five or six more passes left in this field. Nice to just have try to have a relaxing day, get some work done on the farm, connect with the fans of the channel, so to speak. Fairly busy, so I haven't, it's been a while since I did a live stream, so I want to try to do a bit more live streaming. And I'll do it both on Facebook and YouTube, because I automatically have it set, so if I do a live stream, it's automatically recording it, so I can upload it you know, like when I'm done with this live stream, I can still upload this over to YouTube and it'll play, you know, it'll be available to play over there. So I definitely want to try to always keep them at an hour, you know, because when I record my videos, I keep them at about 30 minutes or less, you know. We all have busy lives, and 30-minute videos, I mean, they go by really quick when you're making them. I don't know how they go by when you're watching. Seems like as soon as I start a recording, it's done. The very first tutorial video that I did is up over 200 views. Couldn't believe I would get, you know, that many views on just a tutorial. I mean, it's one of the four videos I have that have well over 100 views. I mean, I've got one video on the channel that has over 1,000 views, but it's also been up for 2 years now. So, still trying to get it figured out. You know, what people want to see. And, you know, what the community's liking and disliking. Got quite a few new followers on the page, so thank you all for that. No, my GPS line didn't lock in. Now that we got everything set, everything seems to be running really smooth. So, man, it's awesome. Happy, happy, happy. Yeah, what is that? Maybe two more passes? Maybe three? I don't know. Yeah, probably like 2.5. Get this bad boy done. Now I might have to just figure out what I'm gonna plant. Oh, I'm gonna plant corn over here. So, this done here, turn around, nice. Okay, we might get luck, and be exactly, nah, we're not gonna. Be nice if it worked out where there was only one more pass up the field before I flip around and do the end down here, but looks like it'll be like a partial, so I'll just have to freehand that, no biggie. What I'll probably do is I'll just freehand it up and then lock the GPS and go back down. And then finish the end row down here, and then this field will be completed for tillage, and then we can move on to the next job, the next program. I use course play a lot on single player maps, you know, just because you're not obviously playing on a server where you have people you can have give you a hand. Yeah, see, just this wee little bit. So, zip over here, run up this edge and get it done. And I should probably even make sure that I have the most current version of Courseplay. It's being constantly updated because it's, no matter what, it's beta. It's always beta. Until just before the next version of the game comes out. And then it's, you know, a completed, polished version of Courseplay. So. So hopefully, Giants really starts listening to the community and starts making sure that the base game is good to go. I mean, honestly, they should, for 21, they should honestly just build upon, you know, this engine instead of, you know, trying to completely reinvent the wheel. That way, when 21 is released, we're not basically beta, you know. When 2019 was released, I mean, their American map was deplorable, you know, and there were so many different patches and updates and things that had to happen right off the bat just to get everything to work right. So, it'll be, you know, they're obviously working on it right now because they usually release in, like, September, October of the year prior. This 19 was released in like September or October of 2018. So let's get it right, boys, and make sure, let's get seasons built in right off the bat. Let's get a really good American map this time. You only got like 8 or 9 months to get her done. It was a big jump to have John Deere equipment added to the game, so I mean, that's pretty BA. Let's move this 90 degrees. Is it? For whatever reason, still thinks I'm running the big cultivator, which I'm definitively not. It's not 120 feet wide. This end row done here. And then we can plant. Plant. Get some more planting done. There's two of my fields. One's planted in wheat, one's planted in canola. I need to plant a small cornfield, which I think I'm just going to use this one as that. And then I need to do a decent sized soybean field. Turn around again. pass, and that should be done. I gotta get a pressure washer for the shop too. So I got some really, really dirty equipment. Start getting stuff put away and placed where it needs to be. Some of it's a little haphazard around the main shop. Plus I have room over at the farmhouse to put stuff. Because right now it's just there for looks. I might have to come over here and knock a few of these trees down that are in the way. Because it gets a little tight when you're trying to turn on the end row there with some of those trees that are sticking out fairly close to the field border. All right. Now that we got that squared away, get this thing picked up, start folding up. We'll turn the GPS lines off. Let's head over to the farm. Get going on our next project. I gotta get this equipment off the field and back to the farm. I do like having the dynamic mud. That's pretty awesome. Pretty awesome. Can't really go wrong with that. Might have to get rid of that tree too, because man, this lane is narrow. At the same time, it's not like I'm bringing any real big equipment down through here, so. So now we got this. Let's get to the shop. And I want to check the weather. Thing. Make sure that next field doesn't need to get tilled under for any sort of, it's already cultivated. So it should be just plant and go. Let's check our map here and see what field 78 needs. Nothing. Sweet. So now that we got that, let's check the weather here. So we're still We're still one day away from planting beans. I think I'm gonna go for it. I'm gonna try it. So let's get the here's the big planter, which I'm probably gonna have to refill anyway. Yes, I need to fill it up with s seed and fertilizer. And then get this guy going. Get this guy going on that field. Getting a little laggy. Just changing my encoder settings. So I keep getting encoder errors. Wonder why it's doing that. I mean, a lot of this stuff does have a fair amount of detail to it. Let's see which fertilizers first. Which should be this first bit. Yes. So let's get the fertilizer filled up. This going. All right, fertilizer's full. Let's fill the seeds up and then get course play going on getting the beans in. Let's put the auger back, set up the soybeans, let's get over to the field and get course play going on here. This keeps persisting. I still gotta do something. All right, we're at the field. Let's leave it there. Let's generate a course here. Why is it not recognized in this field here? Let's make sure it's just gonna scan this field. This is 78. 78. We want to do two headlands, but we want to do those last smooth corners. There's nothing in the way, so we don't have to worry about it hitting anything. Let's get that going. Alright. First waypoint. Return to first point. Okay. So, we got that. Let's go over here and get our service truck. And let's get rid of that. Get back to here. What do you mean he's reached his end point? First waypoint, Bubba. Sometimes you gotta babysit these guys. I just want you to plant the beans. Get rid of beans. Again. Let's try this one more time. Let's come over here. Let's load the gator back up on the service truck. We gotta try to get this equipment that's over here back to the shop. Alright. Gator's on the trailer. Whatever reason, we got course play menu up. Alright. Got our service truck here. Playing in the mud. For whatever reason, the tractors don't quite impact the mud as much as the smaller vehicles. So, which is understandable, you know. But I would think that, you know, as we're getting towards the end of spring, you know, and I really haven't noticed a big difference in how the mud reacts to the vehicles. Hoping, and I think it works, you know, depending on the season, depends on how the ground reacts to vehicles. So, still interested to see how that all plays out. Get the gator back to the farm. Why did I shut it off? Hit the wrong button. Hit the wrong button. That's all. I know the corn planter is already full. So. We got it right here. Right here. Corn planter. Right here. Going for about 40 minutes, so got a few things done. That's awesome. Still fighting encoder problems, so as soon as I'm done with the stream, I'm gonna have to do some research on that and get that squared away because I want to do more than one today. So if it's laggy or looks like crap, I do apologize. Not my intent. Yeah, we need to get corn in over there. It's not a huge field, but a couple acres, 5 acres, 6 acres or something. Try to get it better, looking a little better. And obviously, I really shouldn't be taking this gigantic planter over there, but it's just what I got. Just what I got, so it'll have to work. Because next season I'll be planting a bit more kern. Plus, we got chopped corn stalks in this map, so be mowing that, baling it up, baling it up. I'm gonna try to get course play going on field two here. It'll probably make three passes, and that'll be about it. Birth. All right, so fertilizing and seeding, course generation. Two, one headland around, smooth. See, just a quick little course. That's that. So, first waypoint, return to last point. And set the corn, so let him do his thing. So let's get out of the way of this guy. And then take another piece of equipment back to the farm since I'm already over here. Let's turn the old player speed up a little bit. Let's get to where we want to go in a fairly quick order. So let's take our windrower back. This back to the farm. Like I said, I still gotta get a pressure washer. So I gotta get this equipment cleaned up. It's nasty looking. Nasty. Get a big old corn planter going, so it'll only be a few minutes. This equipment back to the farm. The farm. I think once I get this back, I'll just swing over to the shop and put down a part or a pressure washer so I can get this equipment cleaned up before it gets put away. Then possibly, quite possibly. We might be done with this live stream episode. For a funky little tractor, this thing sure does move right along at a pretty good clip. So, I don't know if anybody else is using it, but it's not bad. It's not bad. Should we put? Where should we put the pressure washer? Let's swing here to the shop. Miscellaneous. Where should we put it? Right here. Right here. Probably right here. Right before you go in the door, kind of thing. Let's get moved around here. Yeah, that should be fine. So at least it's right over here by the door before you take a piece of equipment in and put it in the shed, so. Oh, I need to turn my speed back down. little too fast for this project. This old boy washed up. This can go get put away. One down. Oh, did I hit the baler? I think I did. Or at least I hit the collision point of the baler. Disposed of. Park the funky machine back over here. And then sprayer. Oh, let's check on these guys. Well, he's got like a pass and a half left to do. This guy's doing pretty good. How is that ready to... Oh, it's just... It hasn't germinated yet. For whatever reason. Okay. So everything's looking good on that aspect. Planter or the sprayer needs to be done. Get this taken care of. He needs to get put away. He wasn't really that dirty. Okay, he's get this dude put away. All right. That's done. He's good to go. This guy needs a little attention. Take him over and give him a little attention. Not too bad. Like, most of the implements, I'll probably just keep them outside. And, they can sit outside. But, try to keep as much indoors as I can. During the winter, I can jam, you know, more equipment in the shed. But during the, you know, during the season, I'll just leave, you know, like, most of the implements outside. No reason to try to play musical equipment all the time. I should have been close enough for it to get put away. Get around and get in the tractor. Should we really probably put it down here by this cultivator? Probably try to line this stuff up a little better. Go. Grab this little cultivator. I only got that just for smaller fields. Probably shouldn't even have bought it. Too late. Too late. We're done with this guy. He can get parked in here. Sit outside for the moment. So let's check on our progress of our fellers. What's this guy doing? He can't figure out what's going on here. He's like stuck. He's like stuck. Okay, so let's stop him. And then get him over here. Doing that. That might have been. It's probably a combination of things. Let's go check on our other boy. See how he's making along. He's doing pretty darn good. Have this field planted in no time. No time at all. Let's take another piece back to the farm. Get this back. And at that point, I think we're going to try to get this episode wrapped up. So, hopefully everybody enjoyed the stream. Thank you all for watching. I appreciate it tremendously. Trials and tribulations of trying to learn some new things. I gotta sit and mess around with my video encoder. And it might be because I'm capturing, you know, I'm capturing multiple channels of, you know, both video and audio, and then, you know, the game settings, and you just kind of, I'm not really even maxing out my CPU either, you know, but, you know, I'm probably pegging my RAM just to the max at this moment, so I have to mess around with it a little bit, get it to work all a little bit smoother, and try again. That's all it can do. Try again. And before you know it, it'll be figured out and it'll look sweet all the time. This is a nice little 6R, I do have to say that. This is a nice little tractor. It's a good unit. Kind of that all around good piece, you know. Good chore unit. Let's see here. Our corn's only got one more pass. He's only got maybe the two headlands around, and this might be his final pass down the field. So, let's just get into this guy. Let's just stop him up. Let's just close that out. And I'll just do it by hand. Did the bulk of it. Planner's on. Oh, only just a little piece. Only just missed a little piece. Get this last row finished up. And we're going to call that an episode. Beautiful. there we have it. Pick this guy up. Fold them all up. And thank you all for watching, spending a little time here on the channel. I hope everybody has a great first day of 2020, and we'll see you in the next one.